I bet you never expected the Lumix S9 could take Astro photos. You probably think that you can't shoot Astro photos with the Lumix S9 because it doesn't have a viewfinder. Hey, it's Marlene. In this video, I'm going to show you how the Lumix S9, Lumix G9ii and OM-1 cameras work for basic astrophotography. But there's one hidden feature in your Lumix cameras that you might never have heard of that will pop up just when you need it. I'll tell you about that in a bit. For the past few months, I've been experimenting with astrophotography, specifically trying to get photos of the Milky Way. Now, I went camping in May at Alberta's Dinosaur Provincial Park with my friend Ruth. We got up at about 1 a.m. and went to our predetermined spot and photographed the Milky Way. And amazingly, we got some decent photos. It was our first time. But the biggest challenge I had was focusing. At night, when I was half asleep, now I wear glasses as it is, and I found it so frustrating to determine if focus was achieved, even with manual focus, focus peaking, and the enlarged view of the focus area. But there is a solution. Now, if you shoot with OM-1 cameras, you will likely know about starry sky autofocus. I actually do have an OM-1 camera. I bought it for birding before the G9ii was released. Now, I've recently played with starry sky autofocus on the OM-1, and sadly, I did not take that camera camping with me. But had I known about it, I would have even had more successful Milky Way photos. Now, Lumix cameras have a very hidden feature called starlight autofocus. Now, I've tested this on the Lumix G9ii and, believe it or not, the Lumix S9. When shooting photos at night, in the dark, if you press the AF on button back here, or hold the shutter button, you will get autofocus on the stars. Now, I tested this using manual focus as well as autofocus. So if you pop your lens into manual focus and you hold the AF on button, it will work the same way as using full autofocus and holding the shutter button down and or the AF on button down. You'll need to play with this. Starlight autofocus is an automatic feature and it will show up when you need it. You do not have to set anything up with Lumix cameras. If you're shooting stars, you need to hold that shutter button or the AF on button down long enough to engage it. When I was shooting my first Milky Way photos, I messed up and I didn't hold the AF on button down long enough to trigger this feature. Now, when you are in a low light situation, the camera does do quite a bit of hunting for the focus as it's analyzing the frame. By the way, this also happens on the OM-1 cameras. When stars are detected, it will indicate this on your LCD screen. The bottom left corner turns green and you should see the word star for a brief moment. Now you will also hear a beep when it's in focus. And if you have focus peaking set up, you'll see those peaked areas too. Press the shutter fully and get a perfectly focused photo of stars. I've even tested this in the middle of Calgary when there was light pollution and a full moon and both the S9 and the G9ii were able to focus on stars when the sky was fairly dark. I did my tests around 11 p.m. and 2 a.m. in the middle of August. The OM-1 also focused very well in this same situation using starry sky AF. So if you have an OM camera, you just have to set up starry sky AF and it will do the work for you. For the OM-1, press and hold the AF on button, and when the camera is in focus, it will beep. You'll also see a red square on your LCD, and then you can take your photo. Now, initially with my OM-1, I wasn't sure if starry sky AF would work with my Lumix lenses, but I'm happy to report that starry sky works with Lumix and Pana Leica lenses, no problem. I tested the OM-1 with my 12-60mm, the 9mm and the 15mm lenses with no problem. Here's the great news for Lumix users. Starlight autofocus is available on several Lumix cameras, even some older models. So check your owner's manual first because it's not a menu setting you'll find on your camera. It just magically works when you need it. And Starlight autofocus is available on several OM cameras, so there's lots of choice for budding astrophotographers. Chances are you already own one of these cameras if you're watching this video, so no new gear to buy. Oh darn. By the way, if this video has helped you or inspired you, please consider buying me a coffee. I really appreciate your ongoing support. The link is below in the video description, and thank you very much. Here's some extra tips. If you're a Lumix user, just remember that you need to be in night mode or low light mode for this feature to work. And that's automatic too. So if the area you're photographing is too bright, then it may not be activated. In that case, you'll use your regular autofocus single shot mode or manual focus. So check your Lumix camera owner's manual to see if you have Starlight autofocus. All you have to do is go to the search bar in the PDF of the owner's manual and search the word Starlight. Now, camera manual instructions are always a little sparse, but this is a very uncomplicated feature to use. And hopefully this video helps. The best thing you can do is just try it for yourself. Don't wait for perfect conditions or location. My first tests were done on my deck one night when I couldn't sleep. Now, what about the S9? You probably think that you can't shoot astro photos with the Lumix S9 because it doesn't have a viewfinder. But the truth is, I don't use the viewfinder for astro photos because it's really awkward. When shooting stars, the camera is often pointed up at a high angle. I prefer to use the flip-out LCD because that way I don't have to be cranking my neck all night looking up. Trust me, that gets tiring fast. When using the LCD, I can just look at the screen at any angle. So it doesn't really matter if the camera you're using has an EVF viewfinder when using the Starlight autofocus feature. Plus, I like to sit when I'm doing night photos so that I'm comfortable for those long exposures. And sitting in front of my camera like this is very comfortable. And as a bonus, your tripod will be lower, and if you use a smaller or lighter tripod, it will be more stable if it's closer to the ground. So which camera is the winner? Well, let's be honest, you're probably not going to buy a camera based solely on the starry sky focus. So it doesn't really matter which camera does it best. I think they all do a very good job, and they all do better than I can with manual focus myself. You may have better results manually focusing, but in my experience, going out at night with tired eyes, I'm going to utilize the Starlight autofocus or the Starry Sky autofocus feature every time. Have you tried astrophotography with your Lumix or OM cameras? Let me know in the comments below.